Hello and welcome to episode 23 of VocTer Gaming. I am your host, the vocal terrorist, Jesse Rain, and we are jumping straight into this. Game 2 in the Assembly Cup Best of 5 series. Now, spawning in the southwest on Tuldery Malta, he is our Red Zerg. He is one game down. Can he come back to equal the series? He is mTwDIMAGA. And spawning in the southeast, he is our Green Protoss. He is one game up. Can he continue to take the advantage and go 2-0 up in this best of 5 series? He is mouz.MaNa. Now, today is a very special day because it is the 17th of August as I record this. It is my birthday. I am 24. But instead of filling my mouth with delicious cake, I am here recording commentary for you, dear viewer. My very loyal fans that you are, I'm sure you'll all wish me happy birthday on Facebook, like people have been doing since roughly 10 past midnight, making my phone ping. Now, Tuldery Malta is a very, very large map. This is a very GSLE Korean macro expandy map. As such, I will expect to see a fairly fast expansion from DIMAGA, although we have seen him take later expansions, even in situations such as this, choosing to get the spawning pool first. We'll soon see, as he is at 14 food, which is generally the hatch timings. But no, it looks like he is going to delay. Yep, and he does go spawning pool first. This is generally the DIMAGA style. As much as I do like the fast expand from Zerg, DIMAGA does favour the pool first play. Interesting to see what we'll get from mouz.MaNa. I suspect perhaps some kind of forge fast expand on this map. This is fairly defensible with a slight wall off, with your forge, with cannons. Stick a few gateways here. And we're seeing the fast expand. The question is, will we see the forge shortly after? Or will he just go straight into his gateway tech as much more standard Protoss will play? And we are about to find out. He is going the Forge Fast Expand. I am excellent at my job. That is nice to know. I do like the Forge Fast Expand on this map. This Overlord will see it. He will know what's going on, so he's probably not going to do any kind of early push, despite getting the 4 Zerglings out. Does like to make the 4 Zerglings, but does use them for scouting rather than any kind of real pressure. Especially as this probe is getting in and is going to see everything. Now, since you can expand pretty much away from your opponent in these positions for roughly half of forever, I do expect to see a fairly long game here, although hopefully not as long as yesterday's, because that was so ridiculously long. I've still yet to finish uploading it on account of YouTube crashing like a mother. Very frustrating, I know. Is dropping his first cannon here. So we won't be seeing any cannon rushing, thank God, because that is horrendous and makes me very, very angry. Now, as we see, the hatchery is going down for DIMAGA. Very, very late timings on that. 24 food before he lays the hatchery. I'm not sure I agree with that at all. That really does set you back as a Zerg. Especially as he had the probe in there. He knew he wasn't rushing to anything else. So he knows this expansion's going to be here, whatever. These few Zerglings are just going to sit outside this base at the moment, along with the Overlord. Going to watch and see what goes on. Now check, now this is the thing I like. This bit of high ground here, if you park the Overlord on top of it, they cannot see it, they get no vision of it, he does not know it's there, and he can't shoot it either. Until he gets some kind of air unit out. Against Terrans, naturally, they tend to just lift the barracks, float it slightly, and then kill you with Marines. But against Protoss, it can be really, really handy. As we see, both players transitioning into the general expand build. MaNa is walling off here. One Zealot is enough to take down 4 Zerglings, if microed correctly. And is chrono-boosting out sentries for additional defence. He's going to go very, very turtly style, at least to begin with. And DIMAGA, now DIMAGA is doing something I like. He's expanding again very, very quickly. You can afford to get away with that on a map like this. He's gone forward. He's seen the cannons here. He's seen the wall off. He knows MaNa is not about to move out of this base anytime soon. So once again, he goes for the very quick expand. But, da-da-da-da, where is it? somewhere in this space is a Stargate. There is a Stargate coming out. We are going to see Phoenixes and or Void Rays. Phoenixes, very good for harassment. Get between 4 to 6 of them. Fly them around, kill off overlords, pick up drones, kill the drones. If you have 4, you can pick up and kill a queen, which is very, very tasty. And of course, Void Rays are absolute bastards. And it's Void Rays. What a surprise. Void Rays doing not particularly well for Mana in the previous game, having to transition into carriers. But hopefully we'll do a lot better for him today. I don't know why I said hopefully, because I love DIMAGA and I hope this runs the full gamut of the best of 5 series. As we see an Evolution Chamber spawning here. Gonna be getting on with those upgrades as early as possible. You do need to do that, especially against Protoss. I mean, upgrades are important, as you see Ground Weapons level 1 is being trained for Mana. But your upgrades are so important. Protoss generally, apart from Mana, get ground armor first, meaning Zerglings take forever to kill anything. As we see the Roach Warren now going down here, going to be getting out Roaches, very good against the Zealot Stalker combination, especially if you get Burrow and with the, all the Tunneling Claws and other upgrades you can get for the Roaches to help them heal. As we see here, DIMAGA is going to be taking down these rocks and taking this base. But this probe, and more importantly, this Void Ray are flying about. One Void Ray is very much not enough, though. I do wonder why you moved in with just one Void Ray and one Phoenix. That's a really bad move. Generally, you try not to tip your hand whatsoever. You wait until you've massed up about 3 or 4 Void Rays. Instead, he's just going to nearly lose this, already taking hull damage for 0 damage himself. That is a strange move, as this hatchery does now morph to a lair. These rocks are gone. Eventually, this will become a base. As we can see, it is currently a ghost base. These phoenixes are now sitting here, along with this one Void Ray, but the Void Ray is at half health and very low on shields. That was just poor play. And as we see, he is transitioning to the robotics facility now. He's transitioning out of that Stargate play, as it did absolutely naff all. Finally managing to pick up a queen, but again, because 3 queens now out, Spore Crawler's there, he's having to retreat again. This was poor, poor play. Very nearly lost that Void Ray. That's horrendous. Taking more hull damage now on one of the phoenixes. DIMAGA is getting so quickly ahead, and now that infestation pit is going down. If we check the Roach Run, Gleal Reconstruction is Reconstitution rather. I think that's the first time I've called that the right name, which increases the movement speed.